how you doing? It's you know who. You know this is, I don't even need to introduce myself anymore. Anyway, I thought I'd do a video. It's Christmas Day, and what I'm thinking about is I have an idea, something to talk about that happened today. I was hanging out, just got done chilling with a friend of mine, a few friends of mine. Name Jerome and Mario, known them for years and years. You know, Rose is late 50s, and you know, a little bit older than me. Mario's my age, but a dude named Bobby too that I know. But anyway, I was out. Jerome and I were out together walking the dog. You know, my mom's dog watching it. Before she gets back from out of town for Christmas. So. Well, anyway, Jerome was talking about his son, Lil Rome, and he's doing 45 years right now for murder. And his son's maybe 5 years younger than me, 6 years younger, probably a little bit, something like that. But anyway, we were walking, and he was talking about his son, and then suddenly I got slammed psychically with thoughts about his son, you know, and I couldn't think about anything else, you know, it was just thoughts about Lil Rome and a message, you know, coming from the other side, and, you know, I just, like, I couldn't think about anything else. All I heard in my head is, you know, tell this to Jerome. Give it to Lil Rome. You know, God, you need to tell him this. Please tell him this. And Spear kept on bugging me. It was a young black dude with a hat on, slightly to the side. Cornrows with, like, you know, little braids in the back coming down. And, I could see him in my mind's eye, like, clear as day. But, well, anyway, the message was that to tell his son that that everything's all right, it's all good, that he forgives him for what happened. And he's sorry that shit came down like that, shit happened like that, you know? It's, you know, that was the message. And it turned out it was the person that his son shot. So he just wanted to give her basically a Christmas message. It was, that's the way I felt it was, a Christmas message of forgiveness. So forgiveness and love, you know? It's forgiveness and love, you know, that it's going to be all right, that Lil Rome is going to be all right, and that the young brother's with him, hanging out with his son, and you know, and it's all good. I've had similar things happen. I told you about how the gangbangers all say that the people they killed from other sets in this life always come around when they cross over and meet them, for just let them know that it offered friendship and love to them, forgiveness. So. I guess it's conceivable it would happen with other people too, but that was the message for his, Jerome's son. So I told Jerome, be sure to write him, be sure, absolutely sure to give him a message. I said, not from me, but from him, you know, from that spirit. I was just the tool being used. So I think my mind was open psychically. It is open psychically a whole lot today. So I'm feeling really good. There's a good vibe in the air for some reason. Yeah, like I said before, I usually hate Christmas. I've hated it all my life. But today, this year is a little different. I have a different vibe. But anyway, that's what I wanted to talk about. And something else happened too. I'm going to speak on something else related to that. I know a guy, a friend of mine named Rudy. So anyway, what happened with him is that, you know, back in the late 80s, it was like 89, you know, somebody shot him in the back of the head. Somebody he knew, thought he was his friend, but then he was there just trying to rob him and stuff. So anyway, but he survived. Anyway, so his cousin went out and killed the dude who shot Rudy. And this was in 1989. And so his cousin ended up doing like 19 years before he got paroled, I think, 19 or 18 years for that, you know, for killing the dude. But anyway, I was sitting in the car riding with Rudy, this is a couple of years ago, and then all of a sudden somebody popped into my awareness, and it was the young dude who tried to rob Rudy and shot him. And he just wanted to, he was saying that he was around Rudy and just trying to do good for him, trying to help him out. I felt that real strong, that he was kind of behind the scenes from the other side, showing love to him, trying to make up for what he did. He felt real shitty about it. He felt stupid, felt real bad after the fact when he got to the other side. So it was hard for Rudy to hear that, you know, because it messed him up physically so much from that wound and stuff, and emotionally too. It's hard for him to listen to that because he was like, man, well, fuck him, what he did, and this and that. And I guess it's understandable, but the forgiveness has been there, and he's trying to make it up to him. So things like that happen. And speaking of Rudy as well, like it was the same day actually, his mom came through from the other side. And you know, it's a very curious way, like she did it, she's very smart in how to do that, because you know, she started out, the first thing she said, like something kept telling me,